Got to win 35-17. Tell me what you liked about Saturday. Tell me what maybe you weren't so jazzed about after you went back and watched the tape.
Okay, well, defensive performance we liked after those first, you know, we gave up a monster drive, second drive of the game, and then a couple busted coverages in the first half. But other than that, you know, the other, you know, 40 minutes or whatever was good football. Shut them out in the second half, took control of the game, handled the run game. You know, they rushed for way under 100 yards. It was good to see the offense get the ball down the field, throwing. And Tyler Huntley was outstanding. In fact, I think he was the highest rated quarterback in the nation.
How did you feel like your offensive line played?
I thought they played pretty good. Now, there were some deficiencies, and we, you know, there's always room to get better for every position group, and we got to do a better job of hitting movement. You know, we had some slanters and some blitzing linebackers run through that came through clean, so we've got some work to do and got to coach them better in that respect. But they're doing a lot of good things. I mean, they're protecting the quarterback. We're rushing for over 200 yards a week, you know, at least in the first couple games. And like you said, they're keeping Tyler fairly clean. Now, Tyler has, you know, with his athleticism, has avoided a couple sacks that a lot of quarterbacks would have gotten sacked, but his escapability is such that he was able to get himself out of a jam. But overall, I'd say we're very pleased with how the offensive line's played.
You'd like to get Jaden a couple of field goal opportunities, right?
We would. Yeah, we would. He's, you know, we're confident in him. He does a great job. He was perfect today in practice. I think he was 8 for 8. And so, you know, he needs to get a little bit of experience kicking field goals in games. But that'll come. I mean, we're not going to, you know, there's going to be opportunities. And so we'll just see what unfolds this Saturday.
The offensive line's had a good year. You kept Tyler clean. How have you felt about the first two games?
I mean, so far we have 0 sacks, 0 turnovers. It's not just us up front. It goes to Tyler. It's just to everyone pretty much on the offense, even to Coach Led's new offense. So we give credit to everybody. But we're loving what we're seeing so far with production and averaging about 200 rushing yards. I'm not sure about passing, but all we care about are friends and rushing. I'm just joking.
And how did you end up choosing Utah versus some of the other schools you had options to go to?
I think the thing that separates everything else from all the other schools was definitely family. A lot of schools preach, you know, we're family, we're close, we're all this. But when I came here, I could sense something different. Especially coming from a close family of, you know, my own, I could sense when people actually like each other. And especially with O-line, D-line, usually they don't like each other. But we don't like each other on the field. But as soon as we're done, you know, everything's all handshakes after practice. We love each other and we just hang out together and, you know, just chill out at the blocks and stuff.
All right, we've heard the offseason storyline that the offensive line was a question.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, you heard it too.
Oh, yeah, we loved that one.
Yeah, I know you did. So you tell me where you are right now and how good this offensive line can maybe be in a week, in 2 weeks, by the end of the year.
And, you know, the question mark is a legit question. But just rotating with all those new guys gives us even more confidence to know that they can play at a high level. And just it's nice in having, you know, depth at the O-line.
Senior linebacker Francis Bernard with us here on the Kyle Whittingham Coaches Show. So walk me through the first two games. How do you think they've gone defensively?
First two games, I thought we came out the first game firing, you know, all cylinders, doing really well. The second game, you know, was a little slow. But, you know, the second half picked it up. We had the guys play tremendously well, like Bradley and I, Julian Blackman. And so, you know, obviously, you know, we do great things. Now we just need to put everything together and make sure we play four quarters of complete ball.
Tell me about Saturday. What are you looking forward to doing on Saturday? How do you guys get better on Saturday?
You know, if this is a game. Obviously, you know, Idaho State plays in, you know, a lower division, but it's a game to see where we're at, see, you know, what kind of, you know, elite teams don't step down to, you know, average teams level. What they do is they continue to play at elite levels. And so we need to come out this Saturday, play elite, show that we are an elite team, and then show that we are an elite defense. And so I'm excited to see what we can do.
Idaho State on Saturday. What do we need to know about the Bengals?
Well, you're right. They threw for over 400 yards on Saturday. It was their first game. They didn't have a game in week one. Got a big receiver. It was very productive. You know, 6'4", 220 plus pounds. And another kid that's got some size, not quite that size, but big kid, and then a little slot back, not very big, but he's a 10-6 hundred meter guy, extremely fast. Defensively, very similar to what we saw last week as far as line movement and stunts, and being able, us need to be able to pick up the twists and the movement.
Your last non-conference game's coming up on Saturday. What do you want to get accomplished heading into conference play Saturday? Obviously the win, we know that. But aside from that, what do you want to see happen on Saturday against Idaho State?
I think take another step forward with the evolution of the offense. You know, it's continuing to evolve and to expand, and that's, you know, by design. Andy, you know, has a master plan that he's adheres to, and you know, he's installed offenses in several different places, so he knows exactly what he's doing. And so I think just take that next step offensively. I would like to see us get off to a better start as a whole.
Right.
You know, we haven't got off to much of a start the last two games, and so that would be a positive if we could start faster and do some, you know, positive things early in the game instead of waiting until after halftime.